create a plane. Go to Object, Convert to, Curve from Mesh, and you get a rectangular curve. Use this curve as your bevel object. You probably saw my video about how to work with bevel on bezier curves. Basically, when you enter the add menu and go to curve, then you find bezier and circle. A very quick summary of my previous video. Create the bezier curve and the circle. Select the bezier curve, enter the object data properties, open geometry and search bevel. Then you have to click on object and select your circle curve. For a more detailed explanation, check out my video, which I will link in the info card. But now I come to the question. Is it possible to create rectangular shapes for beveling as well? For sure you can create a curve, place your main vector points and adjust the handles by pressing the V key to call up the set handle type menu and select vector. This creates a more rectangular shape for the curve, but is still not 100% flat in my opinion. You never can be sure about this, I guess. And somehow this is as well a little bit unhandy. So how to do this? My advice would be the curve to mesh function. You will have much more control about your structure when you model the curve with vertices and convert it afterwards to a curve. For example, you want to have a rectangular squared shape for this bezier curve. So I add a plane, click on Object, Convert to, Curve from Mesh, Text. Now select your bezier curve, go to the Object Data Properties, enter the Geometry section and click on the Object Function field. There you just have to select a new converted curve. As always, you are still able to modify your bevel object with scale and its shape. You have two possibilities. 1. Create a plane and start to add further geometry. It doesn't matter if you have edges or vertices inside of the mesh. Only important is the outer shape. When you are happy with the shape, then convert it to a curve and use this as the bevel object. Two. Create a plane. Go to edit mode and be sure that every vertex is selected. Now press the M key to call up the merge window and select at center. Result is a single vertex. Now it is possible to extrude this vertex with the E key and start to shape the object. Use the middle mouse button to snap to axis. For rectangular shapes, switch to an orthographic view with 1, 3 or 7 and press Shift plus tabulator to enable snapping. For sure it can be enabled or disabled in this section as well. Now press G for moving and create your shape with exact values. One grid cell is 1 meter. Keep the structure open or close it. It depends on your needs. As before, convert your object to a curve and use this as the bevel object. Feel free to use the custom converted curve as the bevel object, or the object which should use the bevel. Only weakness for the method for convert a mesh to a curve is that you will not be able to create handles when it becomes a curve. I haven't found it so far. Maybe you know this, then please let us know in the comments below. I just found a workaround for this. For example, when you want to create pipes, place your vertices in the 3D space. I used to snap to axis to get rectangular shapes. Now I want to have curves on the corners. To do this, I use the bevel function again. Go to edit mode, select all and press Ctrl plus B, but nothing will happen so far when you execute the bevel with a left click. Important is the bevel adjustment panel on the left bottom place here. Open it and switch from edges to vertices. Now adjust the bevel with width and segments. When you're happy, convert it to a curve and use another curve for your curve bevel. For example, use a circle or maybe a rectangle. I want to mention the add-on Extra Objects, because you need to enable this in Preferences, and all I showed you before works without add-ons. So open the Preference window and enter the add-on section. Search for Extra Objects. I want to mention two add-ons. Add Curve Extra Object and Add Mesh Extra Object. With Add Mesh Extra Object, you don't have to create a plane and merge it to a single vertice. You have much more objects to select in the Add panel, and here we find the single vertice as well. Just to mention this. It is just a little bit faster, you know. With Add Curve Extra Objects, you find much more curves in the Add panel. For example, as well as square or others like polygon or rhombus. Probably those shapes helps you as well to create your bevel curve. That's all so far. Thank you very much for watching. It would be very nice to give this video a like and or subscribe to our YouTube channel for more game dev videos. Cheers!